My name is Christian Baldini. I am the music director and conductor of the UCLA Symphony Orchestra, as well as the Camellia Symphony Orchestra. On behalf of this SOMA, the Davis School Orchestral Music Association, it is my honor and my pleasure to welcome you to the 18th annual Golden Wennberg Music Festival. It's already number 18. Please, a big applause for that. This festival is a showcase of the orchestra program in the Davis Public Schools. Today, you will experience the progression from the elementary school strings program to the most accomplished examples of musicianship in our high school. In our audience today are many key supporters of the award-winning public school orchestra program in Davis. I welcome the members of the Davis City Council and the Davis School Board and the Davis School administrators, principals, counselors, and teachers who are here today. Please, a big round of applause for them. A sincere welcome as well to the many private music teachers who help to guide these students in their musical endeavors. And I would especially like to acknowledge parents, siblings, and many, many family members who support their children in so many valuable ways. A big applause for them as well. There'll be plenty of talking today, but I know you're here for the music and to hear these children who are neatly organized on stage right now. I'm really eager to play music for you. So today's concert begins with their youngest performers, the Davis Old City Elementary Orchestra. Please welcome the orchestra and their director, Ms. Kim Cole. change, and in the meantime, I'm thinking a little bit about this orchestra. The Davis Old City Elementary Orchestra is composed of 6 graders who have had at least 1 year of music experience. This orchestra meets once per week after school and gives many students their first experience performing in an orchestra. The elementary string program actually begins 2 years earlier. Starting in fourth grade, all students have the opportunity to learn a string instrument, meeting weekly in a small group of 5 to 10 students for 30-minute lessons during the school day. There are currently approximately 600 students in grades 4 to 6 in the elementary strings program. When strings students reach 7th grade, they can join a group like our next one, which is walking right in, right this minute, the Emerson-DaVinci-Harper Junior High Combined Intermediate Orchestra. Junior high orchestras meet daily. Orchestra is a regular class in their schedule, whereas the weekly elementary classes teach the fundamentals of how to play a particular instrument. The daily junior high classes teach students how to play together in a full string orchestra. Almost everybody's here, but not quite. I know that I do not need to probably preach to the choir and highlight once more the importance of music education. But I always have fun about talking about this because I'm very passionate about this topic. I work with young musicians a lot as well. And I've heard over and over and over as they get older and they come back and they thank us for what it meant to them to be playing music, to learn the discipline that it takes to master something, to learn the skill to realize over and over that when you start something which is new to you, it might seem challenging, difficult, daunting, but to realize that with hard work, determination, and with organizing yourself properly, you will be able to do it, and you will do it really, really well. It builds skills that can be applied to anything else you will do in life. And it has to do not only with what you do yourself, but with how you interact with others. Music is about communicating, both with somebody who is leading in front of you, or by leading yourself, or with playing among peers, or with communicating with an audience, in this case, you here. Music and making is, playing in an orchestra is like a society, pretty much. Everybody's got a role, and you need to understand that you need to have your own mentality, but you need to be flexible, and you need to compromise where necessary. If you're out of tune and you're not willing to compromise, there will be a problem. But if you learn to match what others are doing, this is exactly this type of experience that prepares you for life. Anything else that you want to do, whether you end up in the board of directors somewhere of a big company, or working as a CEO somewhere, or as a music teacher, or whatever else you want to do in life, you learn how to interact with others. It seems like they're all nice here now. And let me tell you a little bit more about them. Individual students in the junior high and high school orchestras have achieved statewide recognition through their participation in State Honors Orchestra. These orchestras are open by audition to students in grades 7 to 12 across the state. The state honorees in the Emerson-DaVinci-Harper Combined Intermediate Orchestra are Joanna Kim and Jade Landry. Joanna and Jade, please stand for recognition. Thank you. Thank you. Emerson-DaVinci-Harper Combined Intermediate Orchestra. Thank you. The students performing today, and their teachers and parents, can tell you that school music instruction is valuable to students for many different reasons. It provides them with an opportunity to work together every day in a group setting. It prepares them with skills to present themselves before an audience. Students develop a sense of group commitment and positive group identity, and gain a tool for developing friendships and connections that will last a lifetime. And of course, they also grow immensely as musicians. As they listen to each other in this concert setting, the older students, currently seated in the upper tier, just up there, can appreciate how much they have improved over the years. And the younger musicians can also see where they'll be able to go with their talents if they stick with it and work hard. The next group coming on stage right this moment is the Emerson-DaVinci-Harper Combined Advanced Orchestra. The Advanced Orchestra at each junior high is made up of 8th and 9th graders. Their graded experience allows for a more challenging repertoire. Now for me, one of the perks of being MC this afternoon is that I get to be backstage and see what's going on, which is a lot of fun. It's a lot of energy and a lot of people, and it's all very well organized. There are tons of people working here, volunteering. And I also get to talk to all the conductors, which is a lot of fun always. And you get to hear the ins and outs. So I was just hearing from Mr. Brucker how much work it is individually. For example, the orchestra we just heard, the younger the students are, the more time that they need to spend on learning their part individually, each instrument. The first violins, the second violins, the violas, the cellos, the basses. And there is not that much time that they spend together playing as a group. Now, as kids get older, they start mastering their instrument and feeling much more comfortable, and they don't need as much individual help on playing their own part. And so the groups can concentrate more on rehearsing together, which is a really nice experience. All of it is necessary and valuable, and it teaches them that we need to go through certain steps to make sure that we're all comfortable and we bring the level up for people to enjoy. As you can see, this orchestra is a little bit bigger, quite bigger than the previous groups that we've seen. We have a thriving music program here in Davis, and I think everybody who lives here is extremely proud of the energy and the level and the recognition that our music program has in the city of Davis.
Thank you.
The coordinators for this year's Wennberg Music Festival are Babli, Badua, and Shelley Porterfield. Please give them a big round of applause. Shelley is the president of this SOMA, and Babli is a SOMA board member. We are very, very grateful for their hard work. Now, you must imagine that also there are other key volunteers running the scenes behind today's event. I'm very happy to acknowledge them. Here we are, hoping for many, many things from all of you, for Colin Chan, Kizi Gong, Alison Kennedy, Chris Pilon, and Catherine Unger. Big round of applause, please. Some of these people I just mentioned are literally behind me right now, supervising hundreds of students backstage, and also trying to keep them quiet while their peers are playing. Now, today's elegant concert program was designed by Andrea Johnston, a professional graphic designer who generously donated her time and expertise. I think she also deserves a big round of applause. Start hurting because I make it clap so much. Please let me know when I try and make it gentler. We are also grateful to the professional services of Tom Estes for the audio recording and to Davis Mead Access for the video recording of this afternoon's concert. These recordings will result in the CDs and DVDs of the concert that you can order in the lobby during intermission. Now, I've been telling you about the value of music education, how important it is for children, what it teaches them about life. But there are so many other things, and I'm very happy that I even brought a little something to read for you about the relationship between music and languages. This is very short excerpts of an article taken from the Guardian newspaper from the UK. When children start studying music before the age of 7, they develop bigger vocabularies, a better sense of grammar, and a higher verbal IQ. These advantages benefit both the development of their mother tongue and the learning of foreign languages. During these crucial years, the brain and its sensitive development phase, with 95% of the brain's growth occurring now. Music training started during this period also boosts the brain's ability to process subtle differences between sounds and assists in the pronunciation of languages. And this gift lasts for life, as it has been found that adults who have musical training in childhood will retain this ability to learn foreign languages quicker and more efficiently than adults who did not have early childhood music training. There is more about this, but it seems like the orchestra is nearly ready. But I'll tell you a little bit more about this very interesting study later on. We'll have time, I promise you. The town of Davis has four junior high schools, Emerson and DaVinci, which share a campus, Harper and Holmes. The Emerson and Harper orchestras are both conducted by Greg Brucker, which is why we perform the combination today. The Holmes junior orchestras are conducted by Angelo, Moreno, who also directs the high school orchestras. Please welcome the Holmes Intermediate Orchestra with Concertmaster Albert Chang under the direction of Angelo Moreno.
Thank you.
many junior high and senior high school orchestra events, including today's concert, are made possible through the organization and volunteer efforts of this DSOA, the Davis Schools Orchestra Music Association. This DSOA is an organization of parents of the junior high and high school music students. This DSOA supports the orchestra program through event planning, fundraising, advocacy, and outreach. If you would like to learn more about this DSOA, please visit their table in the lobby during intermission. Would this DSOA board members in the audience please stand and be recognized? splendid first half of the concert. We will now take a 15-minute intermission before the concert continues with the Davis High School Orchestra. Please go out and explore the lobby where you can visit these Zoma exhibits and order CDs and DVDs of today's concert. Thank you.
Yeah. on your side, you're on stage left. They don't care if there's audience or not.
Thank you.
High School Ensemble is composed of 9th to 12th grade students from Davis Senior High School and the Lynch and Charter Academy. The High School Orchestra program has about 150 students in total. Membership in the Baroque Ensemble and the Symphony Orchestra is determined through audition every spring. The Chamber Orchestra is open to all string players with at least a few years of playing experience. On stage, and ready to start off the second half of the concert, is the Baroque Ensemble. This group plays in specially converted period instruments, whose cut strings and Baroque-style bows give it a distinct period sound. Note, for example, that the cellos don't use end pins, and the violins and violas play standing rather than seated position. You will also notice that the conductor does not use a baton. Please join me in welcoming the Davis High School Baroque Ensemble led by concert mistress Jacqueline Liu and conducted by Angelo Moreno.
Thank you.
have some exciting news for you. The Baroque Ensemble will be making a tour of Italy this summer, performing over 10 days in Cremona, Verona, Venice, Montecatini, Florence, Orvieto, and Rome. This is quite a remarkable tour, so we'll be finding out a bit more about this later on. You can find more information about it in the lobby. The unique nature of this ensemble provides for many performance opportunities here at home as well. While universities, including here at UC Davis, often provide a Baroque ensemble and music instruction, the group you just heard is the only high school Baroque ensemble in the nation. Humans first started creating music 500,000 years ago, yet speech and language was only developed 200,000 years ago. Evolutionary evidence, as interpreted by leading researchers such as Robin Lambert from Oxford University, indicates that speech as a form of communication has evolved from our original development and use of music. This explains why our music and language neural networks have significant overlap. While children who learn music become better at learning the grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation of any language. Music training plays a key role in the development of a foreign language in its grammar, colloquialisms, and vocabulary. One recent study found that when children age 9 and under were taught music for just 1 hour a week, the research concluded that they exhibited a higher ability to learn both the grammar and the pronunciation of foreign languages compared to their classmates who had learned a different extracurricular activity. So everybody involved with the school orchestra programs in Davis, you're doing something very good to your children, and I think you deserve an applause to yourselves. Continue telling you about different things because we're still setting up, and this is quite a large orchestra. So for those of you who might not know, and I know you have some information in your concert programs, I want to tell you a little bit about Bodenwenberg and why this festival is happening. Bodenwenberg was an inspirational music teacher in Davis, where she lived with her husband Richard and her children Bodil and John. Bodil was active in music programs in public schools, university, community, and she also was a member of the Camilla Symphony for 17 years. I feel particularly honored and touched of being the MC tonight, both because I'm a professor here at Davis and I'm also the music director of the Camilla Symphony that Bodil Lambert played in. So it's a double special deal for me. She was born in Odense, Denmark, in 1939, and she graduated in nursing from the Copenhagen University Hospital in 1961. She then immigrated to the United States the following year. She discovered the cello in her late 20s and quickly became recognized for her special ability to nurture and love of music and to instill joy in expressing it on the cello. For Bodil, performing music was an expression of life and a vehicle for communication among friends. And she regularly coached junior and senior high students in chamber music groups. Bodil died too early in 1994. The bequest of her cello to the Davis School's music program launched the Wennberg Foundation, later incorporated into DeSoto, which supports the Davis School's orchestra program and the annual Bodil-Wennberg Music Festival to this day. We know that her husband doesn't live here in town, but I know that he was here last year. So I think it's a moment for remembering her, thanking her for all what she did, and feeling very grateful that somebody with such a noble spirit lived in our community and inspired all of us to be here today. High School in February for the world premiere of the Red Velvet Violin, complete with puppet show. The symphony is also in the early stages of a planning a 2015 tour to New York City, featuring a performance in Carnegie Hall. I think that deserves an applause. Students, please stand when I say your name. Anna Hodgson,
Thank you.
selection for the afternoon features the winner of this year's Davis High School Concerto Competition. The concerto competition is held every year in January. Any high school instrumental musician can enter. This year's winner on piano is Victor Troy. You can see right this second the beautiful Steinway nice grand piano is being brought on stage for Victor's performance. I'm going to tell you a little bit about Victor. He's a senior at Davis High School. Victor was born 17 years ago here in Davis. He started piano lessons when he was 4 years old with Wei Ping Chen Lin. And he still takes lessons from her to this day. Victor has participated in Certificate of Merit and MTAC programs and hopes to continue piano after high school. Victor plays the cello also with the Davis High School Symphony and is on the track and field team at Davis High School. So he must be pretty busy, and I'm sure his parents are pretty busy too, taking him around to different kinds of things. As are most students right here on stage, everybody seems very nice and serious and alert and concentrated on what's just about to happen. Remember that we're recording this. If you have your cell phone, make sure that it's off, because Victor, I'm sure, would want to keep a nice recording of this. And the microphone is being placed right there. You seem to be nearly good to go now. Almost. Victor will be performing the first movement of the second piano concerto by one of the composers you guys guessed, Camille Saint-Saëns. Are you excited? Yeah? musician. To the symphony members, to Mr. Angelo Moreno, terrific job. Also Victor's family for the support and help they've given him. And his wonderful teacher. See you again at Wennberg 2015 next year. Thank you.